You are part of a new class of astronauts selected to take part in the first manned mission to Mars. Your friends are kind of salty they didn't get picked, but if you worried about every time someone was jealous of you, you wouldn't have time to be an astronaut. The plan is to get to Mars in 3 steps. Sounds easy enough. They finished the first step last year, completing the Orbital Rocket Assembly Station, or ORAS. You wonder to yourself why that acronym sounds so familiar. The next step in the plan is to establish a permanent base on the Moon. You sit atop of an old-fashioned looking rocket. It was produced by some new private company that beat out Elon Musk's SpaceX design by using cheaper materials and labor. You try not to focus on the reality that the government prioritized cost when awarding the contract to design and build the controlled explosion you are sitting upon now, but you are only mildly successful. The launch goes smoothly. The celebrations at Mission Control seem more than called for. You wonder to yourself if that is in any way indicative that they were not expecting this success. No time to wonder. There is work to be done. You reach the Moon. The automated landing system places your craft down in an area where several unmanned supply craft previously landed. They contain the supplies you will need to establish the new base, but you immediately notice a problem. You are here, and the supplies are there, but there is a small canyon in between the two. You wonder to yourself if Mission Control has ever heard of a topological map. You radio Mission Control and let them know of the problem. You have a 16-meter canyon to bridge, but only have 2 10-meter-long aluminum I-beams and a 50-meter spool of steel cable to construct a bridge. Of course, the welding equipment is in the supply ship on the other side of the canyon, so you can only construct pin connections between structural elements or use multiple bolts to approximate a fixed connection between parts. Mission Control comes back to you with their solution. They tell you to simply cut one of the beams to a 6-meter length and bolt it to the 10-meter-long beam, creating a 16-meter-long beam that can span the canyon. You are just about done trusting their judgment, so you decide to quickly analyze the problem yourself. The bridge will experience a number of different load cases, but you decide that a uniform loading of 12 kilonewtons per meter should provide a good worst-case loading condition to analyze. You are particularly worried about the loading at the joint, as the bolted connection is going to be much weaker than the beam itself.